It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review live on Facebook. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show, first of all, this live show, you'll have a chance to win Marty live, which is probably one of the best apps to come out since WikiTest. Everybody here is using it. It's absolutely fantastic. We'll tell you how you can win very, very shortly. First of all, should we talk about our first release?
Our first release.
First release that we're reviewing this week is... do you want to mention that straight away?
We need to mention it straight away.
Oh, God, I'm glad you're here.
Because on this bit of paper is written a specific minute of the show.
Could be 12.01.
Could be 12.01, yeah.
Could be 12.29.
Now, if you comment on that specific time, so don't guess the time, make a comment at the specific time that we've got written down here, then you'll actually win the Marty app, which we'll be talking about much later on, for free.
But only 5 attempts are allowed on
five comments, because otherwise somebody could sit there just going dot, 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 and could, like, literally keep doing that all the way through. That's what could happen. They could just be going dot, 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 dot.
So you're
going
to get five.
You can only comment five times during the whole show. And if you comment at the specific time, that is the time written down on the piece of paper, you could win Marty app. So it's worth quite a bit of money. It's a great giveaway. And we've got some hairball action going on. Oh, cough up the hairballs onto my lap. It's always good when that happens during a live broadcast. So that's how that works.
I was going to be in full view the whole time.
We're just going to leave it in this glass box with a lid on the top. And nobody's going to bother about it.
Okay, there it is.
Right, first up.
So you said, hang on. That's not bleeding through.
No, it's bleeding through the back.
That's okay. Cool,
so you could comment at any time, but 5 comments maximum. If you commented more than 5 times throughout the broadcast, it will not be allowed. Could be any time, from 12.01 to 12.29. First of all, we've got the Everlast Ring. This comes in various different sizes, and it's a piece of mentalism. If you don't know what this is, the kind of effect that it can create is...
a piece of card, and you can hold it there, and you can ask someone to think of a number between 1 and 100.
Right. They see you write the number
down. You write the number down with a pencil. Onto the piece of paper, and you ask them, think of a number between 1 and 100, and you can turn it around to show that it is the number that they're thinking of, which you've previously written down. What did you think, Dave?
Well, it's only about a 15-minute tutorial. That's one of the effects that you can do with it. Also, there is an effect where you write various different things down, then give them an eraser, and they take that eraser and rub the piece of paper, and magically everything erases.
I had a problem with that bit.
Let's just go through the effects. All that bit of paper, or the number, that number on the bit of paper is the only thing that doesn't get erased with the eraser. Or there is taking the piece of card, writing something on it, their name or something like that, and then you put that piece of card down, and it animates under a hanky, which is a different effect, but you're kind of combining it with this effect.
Yeah, you don't get that with it.
And then the number or the message has been written on the card. They were the three things that were discussed quite briefly during the 15-minute tutorial. But what you get is to wear while you're doing these amazing bits of magic, you get this rather lovely ring that you can wear. So it's a lovely fashion accessory while you're doing this piece of mind reading. Would that be fair to say?
It's fair to say. Yeah. I know. I've got no big problem with the thing that does the magic.
Wearing fashion accessories while you're performing?
No problem with that at all.
Some guys like to wear them on their thumbs, you know, every now and then.
They
like
do,
that.
Don't they? Yeah.
You know, I don't know, but it's here. Sometimes people wear them on their thumbs. Mm. And it's quite a nice designed ring, if we just talk about the ring.
It does look nice.
And you've probably already got things that you do with a similar type of thing. And this might enhance those and make those routines a little bit more clearer. So I don't have a problem with the gimmick per se. What I think some of the routines on there maybe aren't as direct to mentalism as they could be. And I think they're actually detracting from some of the magic. For example, the one where you get people to scribble over a bit of paper, they name a number, then you rub it out and the numbers then predicted on the paper would be so much more direct if it was, say, a room key prediction, or if it was actually written on just, you know, I've got a piece of paper here, name a 2-digit number, bam, there you go. That's direct, incredible, invisible deck level type mentalism, whereas the other stuff confuses them. The audience actually forget and they get confused as to what the effects are. So whilst I like the gimmick that you get, I'm not sure about the specific effects that you get with the gimmick, but you will have your own effects.
We see you like it. It is a nice thing. In terms of the way it's been made, though, I've got an issue with that.
Okay, go on, Wayne.
Because I would find that the where you can see on the in there, it would be uncomfortable, and it actually could. I think
it's a little bit rough underneath it. This one that we've got, it seems a little bit unfinished.
Are you not prepared to suffer for your magic?
It's got this little bit of a knobble just underneath there, and it's a little bit charring.
I think if you wore that over a space of a couple of hours, it would make a little bit of a wearing. It would wear away on your skin. That's sharp. That is sharp. And they could have made that a lot smoother.
It is. And I suppose if this becomes your staple effect, if you're using a lot of these, then you're absolutely right. That is going to start causing you a problem at some point.
Other than that, it would have been all right. Well, I've got another little thing as well. It comes through on pencil.
Yeah.
I think I want something.
What's wrong with that?
I think
that's a bit much, a bit too much of a criticism. It's all right. In mentalism as well, you've written something down, you put the pencil down.
Yeah, but if you want it to come to market, I think everyone uses Sharpies. It would be great if it was a Sharpie.
Well, that's a magician.
Yeah,
but you want to die. This is a really tidy piece. It's clean, tidy. It can be with you all the time. And I love that, like I call coffee shop magic. It's with you all the time. So when someone says to you, can you do a magic trick? You can.
I'm really surprised. I thought you would like this a lot.
I do like it a lot, but there's a couple of flaws where that sharp, I wouldn't be wearing it. I'd only actually take that out as a performance. I wouldn't wear it all the time. Well, you should be wearing that all the time because it's a great little thing. And I just would like to see it. It just seems to be strange. In a performance level, why would you change over from a pencil to do it and then when you've got a Sharpie to sign your cards with as well? Just
no worries.
Why not use a Sharpie pen? I still like it, though.
If you've got a bad broadband connection, there's a few people saying that they can't see the show, it's stopped and keeps pausing every now and then. I think that's probably because of your internet connection at this point, but we will be uploading it to YouTube as normal straight after the show. So don't worry about that, but it is definitely live right now. It's your internet connection. Ellie Morgan left a comment, Wayne, one of her five comments, to say that they're loving 52 to 1.
Thank you.
Loving 52-1. They saw it the other night.
Ellie, and, who's that, Ellie?
Ken says we're being live and gutsy.
Thank you.
Cyrus says, I've seen another review where the build wasn't amazing either. So I think they seem to have that not perfect soldering on more than one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not that just yours. Sense. So right. Cyrus, okay, this is one thing that's great about doing it live. I kind of said I don't know if this is ours, the one we've got, but Cyrus has just confirmed that, you know, that this is the case with it. Henry White, the 24-hour magician who's always on Facebook, he is the 24-hour magician. This is
well done, Henry.
You need to get that website name. Henry just informed us that he can see the live feed perfectly, so thank you very much.
Cheers, Henry.
That's one of his five comments. Don't forget, if you comment during the show, you might win.
What are we going to give it?
I'm going to give it. I like it more than you do, actually. I'm going to give it 71%. I say that. We haven't agreed these marks, so I don't know what you're going to say. But I'm giving it 71.
Okay, I'm going to give it 58.
I'm going to give it 65. I think if I like mentalism and I perform mentalism, I'd maybe give it a little bit more. But
just the way it was made to let it down.
Yeah. That's it.
No worries. So they're the first marks. Maybe you could leave one of your comments and say what you would give it. If you've got it already, we're really interested to know what you think about this. Let's mention this Marty app giveaway one more time. So you've already missed the earlier times, but if you comment, it could say a time on this piece of paper any time between 12:01 and 12:29. And if you comment anything, you say a comment like Davey at this moment has put comment number two. He's just put comment number two. Lee Smith said he likes watching the Three Stooges. Lee is very active in the Marty group, actually. He put a great idea up there in the owners group for the Marty app this morning, and I was watching that. Lee is very, very active in the group. That's his comment. If you've actually commented at the time that it says on this piece of paper and you're the person that comments at that exact time, this is judged live right now by World Magic Shop's Jonathan Farr, you will win a code to download the Marty app for free that we will be demonstrating very, very shortly after we've talked about Rift by Cody Nottingham.
Right. Should I do it?
You said we need to mention lads as well, Wayne. You're right about that. So,
shall we do this then, do lads?
We'll do this.
Okay, so this is a card through window type effect, only it's a non-handed version. So the spectator picks the cards, you then go over to the window, you spread the cards all over the window and get the spectators to hold their hands, holding the cards on the window. You then walk round to the other side of the window. As the DVD says, put your hands behind your back. Your face then goes behind the card, so they can't see your face. And when your face becomes visible again, you have a card hanging out your mouth, and you've supposedly pulled their chosen card through the window with your magical super tongue. And that is...
You know, slight of tongue.
he phoned me up doing that last night. It's terrible.
Wayne, what do you think to this? What do you think to the effect? When you first saw the effect, forget what you know about how it's done and you've watched the tutorial, which is very good. The tutorial's good, isn't it?
It is.
Cody does a good job with the tutorial. But very just good. Imagine you just saw the effect, Wayne.
Yeah.
What do you think of the effect? So, like Sean
if
says,
I saw it and I watched him do it, I would say, why are you doing it with your mouth?
Right.
Why aren't you just doing it with your hand?
That's impossible, though, isn't it?
It's impossible with your hand.
Clearly
it's impossible
not.
With
he's
your
done
mouth.
It. He's done it. He's done it.
It's meant to be impossible. It's magic.
Yeah, but it's a magician fool of that.
It's not a magician. It's a meh. It's something.
No, I think this is good. I really do. Because I think you could turn this into a theatrical moment. There's a lot of people, like Wayne, who's argued with me and said, oh, I don't like things in your mouth and that. But Wayne has seen me at gigs and the conference this week doing that regeneration, Blake Voigt with the car, and a massive crowd just going, oh, my God. And
yet
you're doing something with your mouth. And you said, oh, I don't. But you said to me, I don't like it because you're doing it with your mouth. You're biased. You're mouth biased.
When I'm at work. When I'm at work, I'm always putting things in my mouth. Cards, all sorts of things in my mouth. I've not got a problem with putting things in my mouth.
Comment now.
But
you have
I don't like it.
Let them comment. Do you have a problem putting things in your mouth? It'd be interesting if we get comments from right now.
What
I'm saying is...
Do you have a problem with it?
Cards, all sorts of things. But when I do... I think there's similar effects where things go through the window, like the ones that David Blaine did on the television and Diane did on the television, that are using a similar method known in magic that I think have a bigger impact and will impress your audience in a more shocking and a more visual than pulling the card through with your tongue.
Yeah, okay. I like it because the gimmick is very clever. You have to have a little bit of a setup, and you couldn't do it with like a shirt and a tie, and it's almost sort of casual setting is how you'd present this. Because it's kind of got some restrictions.
Yeah.
But I do like the theatrics of it. And I think it's definitely a little bit more theatrical. And I like the fact... I know what you're saying, Sean, about the cards through the window. I think it's a great trick. But for that trick to work, you actually can't create that moment of drama as a performer. Do you know what I'm saying? So in that effect... You have the card chosen, tear the corner off or whatever, and you turn, you throw the cards, and the spectators don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
The best thing about this, the main positive, is you can stage it as a theatrical piece that you kind of get the window examined. You can really, if you wanted to, I'm not saying do that, but if you wanted to, and that's the main advantage with this, you could turn it into a full theatrical piece where you could get the window examined. You could then put the cards up, you're then going round the other side, you're bashing on the glass of the door, you're showing your hands empty, and it's more like you're doing a mini illusion. So
you leave your hands on the window and the smoke comes from behind
exactly.
The cards.
If you wanted to do this, you could. But my point is, with this method that Cody has created, it rather than just a rushed, oh, now, look at it now, look at it now, it's better than that.
Yeah.
It's actually better. Because you can build it up, you can make it theatrical, which is what I love to do with close-up magic. Take a trick, and I think...
You are good at that, guys.
How do I make it seem more like I'm doing an illusion in close-up conditions rather than just a trick?
Yeah, I
understand. That's why I like it.
Okay.
I couldn't do it because of the clothing restrictions and how I dress for most of my bookings, but I love the effect, and I think it's great, and I think Cody does a great job on the tutorial. How much are you going to give it, Wayne?
Okay.
Comes with the gimmick. Principle comes with the gimmick as well.
The principle and the gimmick is all very good. I just couldn't see the point, and it would be unfair of me to mark it low just because you're losing your mouth, using your mouth. I still think it's worth 83%, though.
Yeah, for my worry, it works. I'm always going to compare it to throwing the cards at the window, but it does work. I'd give this 71%.
I'm going to give it 82%. I think it's worth 82%. I don't think I'm going to do it, but actually I watched it. I watched the trailer, and anybody that watches this trailer and thinks, do you know what, I'd like to learn that. Yeah. I dress in a similar style to Cody. I believe I could change this into a theatrical piece. I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Right. I think it's a great effect.
Okay.
And I think it frames the moment of magic really, really well.
Okay.
That's it. Should we talk about Marty now?
Should we talk about Lads?
Yes.
Lads.
Let's do Lads.
Sorry. Go on then, Wayne. Co-convention organiser. Talk about Lads.
I at Coco. Thank you. What do you want me to tell you? You
need 24th of September.
24th of September. It's the last Sunday of the month. Get down there. Are we going to do... Are we going to have a look? It's turning into a... A weekend, this is now. It was always a Sunday.
Well, thanks to John Carey, it is.
Saturday night, John's going to be doing a little hands-on thing, a little lecture thing for us?
Well, he's basically wants to organise sessions, and he's just said, can I just do something? Can I take care
Brilliant
of it?
Idea.
And
Brilliant
he,
idea.
And what he wants to do is, he likes the atmosphere of the videos that have been shared, that kind of thing.
It's all live. It's all live, folks.
Can we go and have some water?
Enjoy that one, yeah.
This is Blamo's hairball experience. What happens? He licks himself sometimes. He was grooming himself about an hour before the show. He likes to be ready for Facebook Live.
It takes us he 4 days to edit the hair, this, normally.
And then he has to get it out, normally.
Bless his heart.
Live on the show.
Yeah, so, I mean, it has turned into something, almost a weekend thing, and I can only see it getting bigger. The great thing that I love about Lads is that we are producing... the dealers who come in, and they're starting to treat it really serious in the fact that they start to say, well, hang on a minute, I'm gonna release a brand new item for
this. There's a lot of dealers that do that. I know you do. World Magic Shop does. So many people came along last year, just shy of 300 delegates came, and it was an amazing event. Like, we're still not releasing any lecturers' names. And the reason we're not doing that is because it's still at that introductory price.
Yeah.
Where you actually register for the Lads Convention, and John, who's on World Magic Shop, maybe he'll put a comment up with the link or something like that. Mm. But you can register for Lads today, and you actually get a £10 voucher for the World Magic Shop stand.
Yeah.
So I think it's £20, but you get a £10 voucher. But at some point, as we start to announce the lecturers... Two international lecturers and three UK lecturers. One is a double act.
Yeah.
A double act lecturing this time. Together.
That's going to be the one for me.
It's going to be fun.
That double act. That's going to be the one for me. That's one for me.
So if you leave it till after that time when we start to announce lecturers, then at that stage it will go up in price.
Yeah.
All right?
Cool, yeah.
Let's talk about the Marty app. So yes. Marty came out about 15 days ago. It's taken the magic world by storm.
It has. John has
put the link on for Lads. Thank you very much for doing that, John, over at World Magic Shop HQ.
What if he wins the Marty app? Because he posted that. Because he knows what that time is. This could be the scam. He knows what that time is. He's going to put that comment on so we don't have to give the app away.
You're out of order, John.
We'll have to see.
I'm going
to
go... Up.
Kai has just put winning comment up. Davey made a comment a few minutes ago, which I did see, saying his girlfriend only watches the show for Blammo, which is fair enough. I know how that feels with my partner as well. It's the only reason she moved in. Right, okay, so should we try and demonstrate this?
we can talk about that later if you want, but not on the show.
Personal problems later, thank you.
Do you want to give a brief overview of what this is? Oh, no,
let's just do it.
Wayne, I'm going to flick through these cards. Come out, say stop.
Stop.
Just there. Thank you, Blomo. I'm going to get all these, they're all different, but I'm going to get you to hold on to this card while I take a picture of it. Can I get you to hold on to that?
Okay.
Pinch it, finger and thumb.
Yeah,
just there at the bottom if you could, that'd be good. Pinch your finger and thumb. I'm going to take your picture, just lean back a little bit. Stay there, I want to get you in as well as the card.
This is nice and relaxed, isn't
it? Yeah, I was thinking that. Put my leg over your leg like this, that'd be good.
And that is great. My phone's on silent, so... But that's fine. I've taken a picture.
All right.
And I've stored that picture of you. You, I've got that card now. We can shuffle it into the deck. This is an unknown card. You never show the spectator this card.
No,
the one that was freely chosen.
Yeah.
And they're then holding on to this card. And genuinely, all these cards are all different.
Yeah.
Now, what we need somebody to do, we need somebody to comment the card. The name of a card. So, the next card that comes in on a comment. Now, as we're watching it live, the comment we've got here is Greg Chipman. And he's put comment 4. We might be behind you or slightly ahead of you, but we need somebody.
I've got one. Which?
Four of clubs went by. Right, okay. Oh. Matthew said four of clubs.
Matthew,
you happy with that?
Yeah, let's do the four of clubs.
Four clubs.
So it could have been any card, but Matthew said four of clubs. Literally all these cards just came in, it whizzed up the screen or something like that.
We're done with cards now. So, we're done with cards now. Well, that can actually count as your...
Yeah, you might win by
cards. If I unlock my phone...
So it was the four of clubs that you went for, right?
I'm going to unlock my phone right now.
Which is what Paul Daniels always used to have picked on the television, because Ali said it was the most visible card in the pack.
Now, this is the crazy thing right now, ladies and gentlemen. I could show you this on my phone, but if you're my friend on Facebook, if you're a friend of my personal profile...
I'm going to friend you.
...on Facebook, you will see... that actually I've uploaded already, not just now, but actually a minute or so ago, I uploaded the picture to my own Facebook page, and that is the picture that I took, and I'm bringing it closer to the camera to show that right now. And that
good side
is Wayne Fox holding the four of clubs. Right there, the four of clubs. That's the four of clubs right there. And that is on my Facebook page. So the great thing is, you can actually tell people now that they need to go to the Facebook page to see the reveal.
It's incredible. So this is actually so good. And guess what? People are, you're going around, you do this a few times at your gigs, or if you know somebody that wants a business card, whatever, you just do this trick on them and you're instantly connected on Facebook.
And it's also, it's a real picture as well, I can't stress this enough. And it's in your camera roll as well, so you can forward that to them. But the best thing for me is the fact that it goes onto a Facebook page.
Yeah.
Myself and Wayne were performing at a conference this week.
We were.
For Cisco.
We took it apart.
And on the stage, I performed Marty, and everybody had to visit the Facebook page.
Yeah.
Of the platinum sponsor for the event, they had to visit the Facebook page and see the reveal, which was fantastic. Everybody,
it just, and the place erupted. It was just such a massive gasp. It was brilliant.
The conference was all about entering the digital world. It couldn't have been any more perfect.
Yeah.
But not only that, anybody can use it.
Yeah.
You can use it with your own profile page. You can use it with your own Facebook page. You can use it with a page that you're an admin on, and you can just send the picture there. You can work for a company and promote the company.
You can do this little thing, a close-up, but I can't praise it enough. That morning, or that lunchtime, with 2,000 people watching you, and that massive unison gasp was incredible.
I'm going to put some footage up on my David Penn Leading Magician and Illusionist page.
Yeah.
And I will put some footage up at some point of me doing that reveal for all
those. Yeah, it would be good.
The gasp was incredible. Yeah. And these are guys that work in the digital industry. So it was perfect for the conference.
Blow them away, mate. Blow them away.
Perfect for the real world anyway. And the amazing thing is, they're in the photo. I know there's been similar apps to this in the past. Lee Smith was a guy that really pioneered this plot many years ago, which is why he's such a fan of what's gone on. And even Lee cannot believe, even with all his amazing knowledge with apps, he cannot believe the technology that is behind this. So, absolutely incredible.
Yeah, loved
it. I am literally giving this... How can I not give it 100%? It was part... I've been on stage at a conference, done it for 2,000 people at the O2... And had them all gasp and come off stage, and my client gone, "Oh, crikey, I don't believe that." Everyone's on our Facebook page, it's brilliant, it's the best thing. You can't say any better than that.
You know what? It was only, was it last month?
Yeah.
I got my first 100.
Yeah.
I am actually going to do it again. I've got to. You cannot not. It advertises you. Where else would you find that? If you go and have a look at my website, why?
And they're just
because there's a picture of you holding the card that you didn't know you had. It's just amazing.
I don't want to say too much about it, but they've done updates and the guys. It's such a great team over there in France working on it. They're so passionate about this.
Yeah.
I know for a fact that they were offered some very big money to actually sell it outright to somebody, and they didn't want to do it because they wanted the magic community to have it. And they wanted everybody to be using it and be as passionate about it as they are. Yeah. It's a great effect.
It's great. Well, I've got 2 days at a trade show. I'm doing these little seminar bits before the MD goes up and gives talks next month. And this is it. I have to do that. You can't not do it for them, can you?
And don't forget, we've got about 5 minutes left of the show. If you've commented, the competition is going to end in 2 minutes' time.
Sure. But if you've commented, 100% as well.
100%. 300%.
Is that a first?
I don't think that's ever happened. 100% on the Wizard product review. It's never happened before that we had three altogether. And if you've commented at any point during the Wizard product review today, up until 12:29, so we've got 2 minutes left, we might have found a winner. It's not on Android yet. A lot of people asking about Android. It's not on Android. That might be...
It's all right. He's on the phone to his girlfriend.
It's not on Android just yet, but it might be in the future. You never know, but it's just available for iPhone. Gareth Hobson just commented, burgers. So thanks for that.
What's that?
And Richard John said he's definitely going to drag his iPhone out of the drawer. I don't blame you, John. Last review, trespassing. What happens, Sean, during trespassing?
Well, it's another card through window type plot, but a close-up portable version. Because what you do is you've got your lanyard when you're at a trade show, and you've got your plastic badge that holds your badge in it. You get that, you have a playing card picked, you tear the corner off the playing card, and you penetrate the playing card inside the little plastic badge holder. That's the effect.
Yeah.
I'd like to say convoluted magic at its best, okay. Really. There's, I think you mentioned, you could use sleight of... It looks like you're using sleight of hand to do it. So I was thinking, if you've got a gimmick helping you, it should look like nothing funny's
exactly.
going on. And this looks like something funny's going on. I think there's a lot of setup to do. There's a lot going on to make this happen.
Yeah.
It's not like you can just... if you could... Because I do a lot of treasures. If I could wear this round my neck and just take it off and do it at any point...
Yeah, you can't do that.
I think this was great. That'd be the only place for it. You can't. You kind of got to go up to them and go, this is a trick that I've prepared that I'm going to show to you now. And therefore...
What the issue I've got is that
I think the
way that you look like you are putting that in there looks like how you would do it. It looks like you're up in your in.
It
your
looks
hand.
Like that. You know the colour change. It reminds me very much of the colour change. The fact that you kind of move it across.
You know,
and the fact that you don't just, you know, pop it like this and it goes through and
that's what you want. That
you want
bang
and it's there.
It's visibly in there. That
the fact that you do this, the opening to the container, the badge, is actually here. No, that's just a two. just a two.
Oh, your little tease. Your little tease, Dave.
Just a two, they might be able to see.
Teasers.
So that is there. There's a little gap there. And when they do this, it looks like you're pulling it back and shoving it straight in.
Yeah, right. No, that looks exactly what it is.
It looks like what it is. Even though, when you're paying attention to the nth degree, it is actually better than this. Mm. But sometimes, in an environment where you're performing, it would be good enough just to have the corner of a playing card inside there, you're saying, Sean, just bring it out and go, there's the corner, look, if I rub, it's inside there now. And that would actually be enough, and you could repeat it all day long. With this, you've got a little bit of a setup, you've got to bring it out of your pocket in a little bit of a convoluted way, and then you've got to pass it through the mini window into it, and it's difficult to work for the effect that is not quite as strong.
Yeah.
Not quite as strong. So,
we're going to give it away.
37%.
14. I don't like it. Sure.
I'll give it 41. Only because, say you were doing a little montage of effects that were happening on a trade stand, you might put it in a little trade show.
One little thing, I think what we should say, the video to watch it is
15 minutes.
It's in subtitles.
Subtitles.
And it is a little bit difficult to follow when you're trying to watch what they're doing and then read subtitles. You're constantly, like I was, constantly rewinding it. So what did that bit say? It's difficult.
But it's only about 15 minutes.
I think it's important that people know that.
Right, so it's come to the end of the show. Thank you very much for watching us on the live broadcast. We're also going to be doing another competition as well. If you don't win this time, we've got two other Marty codes to give away. And this is for anybody, especially our American viewers and American friends. Sorry for that you're always in bed when we do the Wizard product review live.
Yeah.
If you just leave us a comment on the video, so you watch the show and leave us a comment after GMT 1220, it doesn't matter, but because we'll be picking somebody from random from those comments. So
that's the fairest way.
Share this with your friends. We'll pick somebody at random at any time over the next couple of days up until next Monday. And also, we have another way to win as well. If you order anything from worldmagicshop.com up until next Monday at midnight, which is the bank holiday Monday, order anything at all, every single order will be entered into a draw to win a Marty app. Okay?
Wow.
For free.
Someone just put a heart up.
For free.
Was that for me?
That was for me.
Your heart went across there. No,
little hearts.
Surely, yeah.
Send Wayne some hearts, everybody. Go on, send him some hearts.
One just went across, I know it was for me. It had a little W on it.
Was it for you? Was it a Wayne heart? Right, let's reveal this.
Come on.
There's some hearts.
Love come in.
You little...
Hang on. Look at this.
That needs to be videoed. People think we're making that up. There's thousands of them.
There we go.
There we go.
Still going.
God, that was lucky, wasn't it?
I hope he doesn't try to call you back.
No.
There we go. Right, here we go. I said put do not disturb.
It's on do not disturb.
No, it's on. How can me call you then?
I don't know, it's on airplane mode.
Right, let's reveal the time. The person that commented at 12:14. 12:14.
Oh, I want to know.
Who was it?
12:14. I've got the name here.
It
who actually
is.
Commented at 12:14? John has been a comment at 12:14 on the show. Was Yarden Aviv. Boom!
Yarden
Aviv, round of applause, everybody. However disappointed you are that you didn't win.
Now let's see the angry faces. Send all the angry faces. Whoever
gets your first angry face.
Send them.
They all
hate you, Yarden.
That's it. Thank you so much for watching, guys. It's been great fun doing the Wizard product review live. Don't forget, any time after the show, that includes you guys that have already watched us, the five comments thing has been erased. That's been erased. You can start again if you feel like commenting on one of these releases, telling everybody about how much you enjoy performing Rift live and how much it is a theatrical piece, or if you've got The Ring and it's not quite as good as you thought it was going to be, or Trespassing and you've actually made it work. Make a comment, tell us anything, tell us about something you want reviewed in the future, ask us a question about Lads. we'll get back to you. But if you leave a comment after the show, you will automatically be entered into a draw to win Marty, which is officially the first product ever to get 3 100%. Until next time, we do this live. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
He's Blamo, and that's it for the Wizard Product Review, live!